What?
Oh, horror.
May I put to you some questions, Monsieur Redfern? How did you and Mademoiselle Brewster come to be rowing together?
I asked Miss Brewster if I could join her.
Why did you do that? Monsieur Redfern, there is no longer the luxury of playing the little games. Now is the time for truth.
Helena and I were accustomed to swimming together each morning. When I didn't see her on the beach, I went looking for her. She wasn't up at the hotel. I saw Miss Brewster getting the rowboat ready. That's when I got the idea that if we rowed around the island, I might find her, Helena. I offered to row first. We set off.
What time did you arrive?
Sometime before 12. I don't know exactly.
Tell me what you thought when you saw Mrs. Marshall.
Well, I was put out of the muscle. I couldn't understand why she had been there. I couldn't understand it at all. I rowed for the beach. I wanted to find out what she was doing.
What happened after their boat beached?
I called out to her, but she didn't answer. She just lay there. I went over to her. There was something strange. She was so still. I knelt beside her, touched her hand, then her arm. She didn't react at all. Then I lifted her hand. My God, her face. It was dark, mottled. Those marks, handprints on her neck.
Steady.
I'm sorry. She was so beautiful. How could anyone spoil that?
Who went for help?
Miss Brewster. I had this idea. I wanted to protect Helena. It's stupid, I know. She was beyond anyone's protection. I sat near her, then couldn't take that anymore. I came over here and waited until the police were.
Is there anything you saw or thought that might help us?
I'm sorry. Let me think.
Take your time.
There was one thing. I heard a noise while I was still over near Helena.
What was it?
A clatter on the rocks near the ladder. Something falling. Not a rock, though. Something light.
I may have more questions for you later.
The same color as Helena Marshall's hat. A smashed bottle with a bit of fluid left in it.
And the fluid has the distinctive odor of an expensive perfume.
Looks like a dart. The carving is quite old. That mud looks like it was placed there deliberately. And there's something shiny underneath. I say, a six-sided metal receptacle hidden by the mud. The mud must have been applied fairly recently, and the metal looks shiny, almost new. And that shape, it reminds me of something. It's like the receptacle for a winch handle you find on the mast of some sailboats to winch the sail up and down.
An older ladder that has collapsed? I wonder if anyone was climbing it at the time. Poirot will not be climbing up their ladder. I would like to put to you the questions, if I may.
Of course.
How did you and Monsieur Redfern come to be rowing together?
After you saw me at Rocky Bar, I changed and was about to set out on my morning row when Mr. Redfern asked if he could join me.
What time did you arrive here?
We arrived on the beach at 11:45. We must have come in sight of the cove 5 minutes before that.
Tell me what you thought when you saw Mrs. Marshall.
Nothing at first. I assumed she was sunning herself.
And then?
Well, the first thing I noticed was she was lying as if she was sunbathing, but she was in the shade of the cliffs. Then, when Mr. Redfern called out and she didn't answer, that felt odd too. Once we were out of the boat, I could tell there was something unnatural in the way she was lying. Her arms.
What time was this?
He wanted to row right round the island, so I checked my watch. It was not quite 11:30.
Did Monsieur Redfern often accompany you?
No, this was the first time. If you ask me, he was looking for Mrs. Marshall. He volunteered to take the oars first.
What happened after their boat beached?
Mr. Redfern and I approached Mrs. Marshall. I could see he thought the situation wasn't right as well. He knelt beside her, touched her hand, then her arm, and he started to lift her hat. He saw her face and cried out.
Who went for help?
I did. We both knew someone had to. I'm not the kind of woman who'd ever admit to feeling fear, but I was secretly thankful when Mr. Redfern offered to stay with the body.
I understand perfectly, Mademoiselle. You must have reproached yourself. Is there anything you saw or thought that might help us?
No, I don't believe so. Yes, there is something. She was strangled, just like Millie and the other woman, Alice Corrigan. Three women strangled in South Devon within a few months of one another. Can that be just coincidence?
Anything is possible, Mademoiselle. But I will agree that coincidence in this case seems highly unlikely. I may have more questions for you later.
Of course.
Can you row me back to the bathing beach?
Of course. Would you like to leave now?
Yes, thank you. May I have a word with you?
Colonel Weston told us to cooperate with you, Mr. Poirot, and of course we will, in any way we can. But this has been a very bad shock to me, and Mr. Gardner is always very, very careful of my health. Isn't that so, Walkley?
Yes, darling. Mrs. Gardner is very sensitive.
I appreciate your speaking with me. You spent the morning here, overlooking the beach?
Yes, we did. And not the slightest idea in our minds of what was happening just around the corner in that little cove.
And you were here the entire time?
Yes, both of us. From nearly 10:30, 10:25, until Oakley went to play tennis at 12. Isn't that right, Oakley?
Well, not exactly. I did run off to fetch your purple wool, if you'll remember. That was around 11 by the hotel clock. Quite a few minutes to find it, I'm afraid. 15 minutes, possibly 20.
No more than 10 minutes, surely. I barely missed you.
Methinks she protests too much, Poirot. What is she frightened of?
It is a question we must learn the answer to, my friend. Did you see Madame Marshall at all today?
We? That is to say, no. No, I said to Oakley, why, wherever can she have got to this morning? First her husband comes looking for her, and then that good-looking young man, Mr. Redfern. I always wondered, why must he go running after that woman when he has that nice, pretty wife all of his own, didn't I, Oakley?
Yes, darling.
She can babble all she likes, but I heard that hesitation, Poirot.
Did you notice anything that might have a bearing upon the case?
Why, no. I don't think so, just that she was always around with young Redfern. Anyone can tell you that.
Did her husband mind, do you think?
Captain Marshall is a very reserved man.
That is all the questions I have for the moment.
We're devastated. We know nothing that could help. Aren't we, Orkley?
Yes, darling.